Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, a warm welcome to you all. What a year it has been for science and research. A lot of things have happened over the last 1 year. In August this year, scientists at the Advanced Laser Interferometer Gravitational-Wave Laboratory, Observatory, or LIGO as we know it, detected something remarkable. 130 million light years away, two super dense neutron stars had crashed into each other. Can you imagine that? The collision of these stars sent a ripple through space and time this was detected on Earth. Can you believe this? This was proved. The gravitational waves and the electromagnetic signals from this event added to the remarkable milestones of the past couple of years. Thanks to some astonishing events and discoveries, our understanding of the universe has grown, universe or multiverse, whatever you want to call, has grown in leaps and bounds. Now, I'll give you another example. Even as the Cassini mission to Saturn came to a spectacular end, NASA's Juno mission will start sending us data from Jupiter. Can we imagine that? Now, added to this, look at the kind of things that have been invented in the gene. The CRISPR gene editing tool has added to the scientists' arsenal. Like we IT guys started using word processors for editing text and all of that. Now they can edit the genes to battle against cancer and HIV. Amazing, right? There have been remarkable advances in artificial intelligence and machine learning too. Just to give you an example, researchers at MIT have developed Shelley, the robot, which has been attempting somewhat successful to write horror fiction. Wait till they can automate, you know, the entire proceedings from here and report in future. This list can go on and on. For want of time, I'll stop here. But once you pause to think about it, all these breakthroughs and advances throw up interesting questions about the nature of creativity and what it means to be human at the most fundamental level. This is one of the reasons why we feel proud of the Infosys Prize, which has been recognizing and rewarding the work of individuals who explore these and other questions that have perplexed humanity since the beginning of time. We look up to these exceptional men and women to push up the frontiers of the possible and transform societies. The Infosys Science Foundation, as some of you may know, which awards the prize, was set up with a vision to restore the romance of research. We aim to recognize and reward talent early. The foundation has several initiatives designed to help build the support structure for scientists and researchers. From recognizing contemporary researchers through the prize and spreading the news about their work through pan-India lectures to train researchers and educators and engaging students in the wonder of science. We want to create a pipeline of curious and bold students who go on to think about the boundaries of traditional ideas. I hope the students seated here, some of them are here, who attended the workshop on gravity this morning, have something to think about. Let's now begin, without much ado, the celebration of excellence in the sciences and humanities by announcing the coveted 6 winners of the Infosys Prize 2017 with one small stop on the way to introduce our esteemed jury chairs. I request Mr. Murthy to tell us about the 6 profound individuals without whom the work of Infosys Prize winners could not be judged and articulated to us the way it is. Over to you, Murthy. Thank you.